The average, to show you a little bit about what we're going to talk about here, we're going to talk, one of the slides is going to tell you that the average homes right now have been on the market for 18 months. Well, as you know, Ron, and you guys know probably, right now the average homes that have been on the market that are on the listing, and this is from one end of the spectrum to the other, is about 150 to 160 days. Now, that is 5 months. And there's a reason I'm going to tell you this in a second. The sales, the average days on markets is about 130 to 140, so that's 3 months. Four and a half months. The reason I tell you this is because it's important when you have to understand what foreclosures and how foreclosures work. Foreclosures, there are two types of foreclosures in the state of Nevada. The first type of foreclosure is what we call a non-judicial foreclosure. That's where the lender is allowed to go out and foreclose on your property without going to court. All he has to do is a couple of things, and I'll get to them in just a second. The second one is called a judicial foreclosure. Judicial foreclosure is where they actually go to court. Some of these judicial foreclosures are done because of a deficiency. You get a private lender that wants to do that, and he wants to take it to court. That's where he's going to go. The nice thing about judicial, well, if you want to say nice, the judicial foreclosure takes about 12 months. So people don't want to do that. Also, the part about the judicial foreclosure is that the borrower does have the right to come back and reclaim that property. Okay? That's on a judicial foreclosure.
What kind of time period?
He has a 1 year. Okay? So if they go a judicial foreclosure, it takes him 12 months, then he has another 12 months for to come back and reclaim the property. That does not happen in a non-judicial foreclosure. You do not have the right of redemption in a non-judicial foreclosure. The normal foreclosure, if they were going to do it right by the book, it'd be 120 days. Now, we all know that that's not happening because the banks and the lenders are just overwhelmed, so they can't even keep up with it. But if it's 120 days, and the way it works is very simply like this. The non-judicial is probably the most common, and the sale process, how it works is that once the lender decides that he is going to record a notice of default and election to sell, he can't do that in less than 90 days. It's actually 3 months. He says 3 months, once they've recorded that in the county to which the property is, they won't sell the property they cannot sell it for 3 months. So if you've got a guy that's just right on top of it and you've missed one payment, he can actually file that right away and within 30 days and 120 days, it's over. Okay? I mean, you're out of the house. One of the things that a borrower can do is he has 35 days to cure and bring the loan current. So if he does, he can actually do that 35 days. He also has 15 days before the sale, if he notifies it, he has to file a notice of intent to cure 15 days before the sale, and if he cures it, then obviously, the foreclosure's been canceled. Now, you have to look at each person's mortgage and their loan papers because each lender is going to be different, the way they treat it. And what I mean by that is that the way they treat the loan by specifically when you file and when they handle the foreclosure documents, you have to check with them. So look at your loan documents. A lot of things are going on in those loan documents. And one of the things that we've been able to do in iModification is that we've actually been able to find situations where the lenders have been playing hanky-panky. So good to read those documents. The way it works if you're going to go to sale is very simply this, is the highest bidder gets the trustee, what is known as a trustee deed. If he bids over and above what the bank, now the bank usually comes in and they bid what's owed and plus all the costs. Okay, so if what's owed and all of the fees and all of the late charges and all of these things and what it costs to take it to sale, okay, that's what the bank is going to bid on. If you bid more than that, then guess what? You get the trustee deed and you get the property. Okay? Now, Ron and our counselor here was kind of referring to something that's come up from the federal government. One of the things in the federal government that's come about is that they put $75 billion aside to help people with their loan modifications. And about 1,500 homeowners got modified loans, which is just absolutely incredible because the banks are holding on to their money like they did. So federal government just came down a few days ago and they said, you know, we need to get you guys to loan some money, so we need to sweeten the pot a little bit. And what they're doing is that any loan modification that comes to them, they're going to get $1,000 from the federal government. So for every loan modification, they're going to get $1,000. And then they'll also get $1,000 every year for the next 3 years. This is our money. This is our money, our tax money, being given to the banks just so that they'll be nice to us. Okay? I know this is the world turned upside down, but that's the reality that we're dealing with right now. And that's why one of the reasons that we are doing that iModification is doing such a fantastic job with our clients. And if you have somebody out there that you know owes more than their house is worth, please just ask them to give us a call. Just ask them to come on in, and I'm going to let Ken tell you exactly how we go through the process of modifying a loan and what it means.